Hey, what's up? What's up? What's up? Yes, welcome to today's devotional. I don't know where you guys are watching from, but I'm grateful to be able to have you. And can I just say, golly, it's good to be with you. I personally am really missing human interaction. So maybe that's why I'm a little bit more excitable. Hey, I wanted to take just a couple moments and have some real talk with you today, okay? It's one of the things that I feel like God has been placing on my heart. So if I can, like, just be completely real. There have been a lot of times in my life where I feel like when I've been given the opportunity to speak about Jesus, I have been hindered, where I've held myself back. So maybe it's a Ben thing, maybe it's been a spiritual war thing, but God has really been challenging me in this over the course of the last probably 2 or 3 years. And so Holy Spirit has been doing some really cool things in my life and in my wife's life, but it hasn't been easy. The act of evangelism has, it's been work. It's actually taken a lot of work to be able to adjust my speech, right? When God gives me an opportunity to not just be like, oh, I'll pray for you, but to actually talk about what God has done and how God has been moving in my life and what he's done in the lives of those around me. It's brought me to the passage of 1 Peter chapter 3, verses 15. It says, so keep your heart's attention on Jesus. And keep your adoration upon Christ, who is your master. Be ready to speak up and tell anyone and everyone who asks you why you are living the way you are. And always with the utmost respect and gentleness. It reminds me of a book that I've read, and it's not just a book, it's my favorite book ever. It's a missionary biography. It's called One Witness, okay? This book was written in 1986, but the missionaries, David and Svea Flood, they were from Sweden, and they went to the Congo in 1921. They were some of the first missionaries ever to set foot in the Congo. And as you can imagine, some of the tribes resisted having outsiders. And so this woman, Svea Flood, she ends up getting pregnant, and she is trusting and believing God for this nation. And as the story goes, Svea had the opportunity to interact with one boy. One boy, that is it. The tribes that they were trying to get in contact with kept pushing them back and pushing them back and pushing them back. But this one small boy came to where David and Svea Flood were living, in this ramshackle mud hut that they had built. And Svea would witness to this little boy as he was selling them chickens. As it went, the boy ended up giving his life to Jesus. Svea died in childbirth, and the boy went on to go and evangelize and share Jesus with all of the children in his community, in his tribe. The children then went on from there, and they went and shared Jesus with their parents. As the book fast forwards, Aggie Hurst, the daughter of Svea Flood, traveling in Europe with her husband years later, and ended up listening to the superintendent of the Pentecostal churches in Congo. And this young man who was speaking had been led to Christ because of her mother. And not only had he been led to Christ, but it was accounted to Aggie Hurst that over 110,000 believers were now throughout Congo because she was obedient. Man, that is convicting to my heart. Evangelism is the very gift of being able to speak about Jesus and what he has done. And so friends, wherever you're coming from, man, I want to encourage you today. God has prepared you for this moment. He's prepared your lips and your hearts to be able to speak of his goodness and his glory with all gentleness and all respect. Guys, I love you. I love you. I love you. I love you. Have a phenomenal day, and we will see you soon.